Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we are going to learn how to reverse a string in Java. For example, we have a string Gain Java Knowledge. Then what will be the output if we will reverse the string? This will be the output after reversing the string. So now we will learn how we can reverse a string and which one is the best approach. So here we will write a Java program to reverse a string, and here we will also see which inbuilt function we can use and which is best approaches. So what we will do, first we will do manually, like we will do iteration, we will iterate each keyword and make a reverse string as a output. For example, we have an input. Now what we will do, we will declare one more string as output string that will store the result in form of reverse string. So here I will use for each loop and it will be start from its string length and it will goes up to and loop will goes up to greater than equal to 0, and here we are using iteration loop in reverse. So first it will pick its last character and will add into output 1. After that it will pick its second last character, like this it will pick and add. So here output 1 will be like output 1 dot input 1 dot char at. So here we will use input 1 dot caret index. So here we will pass its index, but it will pick its first character, so it will be length minus 1. So e is at length minus 1 index. So here what we will do, here we will just print the output. Output 1. So now I will run this application and will see the output. So here what I will do, here I will also print input 1. So run this application and check the output if it is working fine or not. So here we can see the output Gain Java Knowledge as input, and this is output in the reverse form. So this is one approach that we can use, but it is not a better approach because it takes more time. So now I will show you the second approach and we'll see which one is best. So here what we will do, input 2. So what I will do, here I will also print the time, how much time this approach is taking. So here system dot current time in milliseconds, so it is the start time. And here I will just print how much time this process is taking, time taken by iteration approach. So what I will do, system dot current time in millis, and from this time I will just subtract the start time. So it will show me the time also, how much time this process is taking in execution. So it is the first approach. So this one is the first approach. Now we will see the second approach, which one is better. So what I will do, I will just copy this line and go here, second approach. So here it will be start time 2, and we'll also copy the same line from here and paste it here, And in this approach, we will use the inbuilt function. And after that, we will see which one is better. So what I will do here, I will take string input 2, or we can use the same as input 1. And gain Java knowledge. And what I will do here, I will use string builder class, and here I will use string builder reverse method. So first here I will create string builder object, and here I will pass input 2. So now our string builder object is ready. So here I will just call sp.reverse method, and after that, so here what I can use, this is parameter 1, output 1, and here we can use sb, instead of sb we can use output 2 and output 2. So here I will just copy the same line of codes and paste it here. So this will be the input 2 and this will be the output 2. So now I will run this application and we'll see which approach is better. So now I will start our application and check the output on console. So here we can see input 1 and this is the output 1, and time taken by iteration loop, it's 69 seconds. And in the second approach, in which we are using string builder inbuilt function, that is reverse method, it is just taking 2 milliseconds and it is taking 69 milliseconds, and we can run it again. So here we can see it is taking 79 milliseconds, and second approach in which we are using inbuilt function is just taking 3 milliseconds. So we can say the second approach is better. We must go for inbuilt function provided by string builder class, because in this approach it's again and again creating one new object. Every time we are adding in output, it's creating new object, so it is very time consuming process. But in this approach, it is just creating one object and adding in the same object. So this is better approach. Okay, thanks for watching this video.